In the last topic, you have seen we have drawn electric lines of force for a system carrying one positive charge and one negative charge. This system is termed as electric dipole. What is it called? Called electric dipole. So electric dipole is an electrical system which consists of two point charges equal in magnitude, opposite in nature. So if one charge is positive, another charge is negative, and these two are separated by a certain distance apart, this is electric dipole. There are so many examples you can see in a practical life for electric dipole, like NaCl, HCl, HBr. All these electronic configurations are an example of electric dipoles. Electric dipole moment. Electric dipole movement. This is a physical quantity associated with an electric dipole. What is it exactly? It measures the strength of an electric dipole. And how do we calculate strength of an electric dipole? Strength of an electric dipole is defined as product of charge into separation distance. SI unit is coulomb meter. It is a vector quantity and direction of vector is from negative to positive charge. This is the direction of electric dipole movement. Is this clear? Now let's find out electric field at an axial point of dipole. So we consider an electric dipole, point A, charge Q. Another charge is minus Q. Point B, separation distance is 2A. Axial point means point lying on the line joining two point charges. This is P. This is midpoint. From the midpoint, the distance of point P is given as R. Right? Now, if we want to find out electric field at the point P because of an electric dipole, it is easy thing because dipole consists of two point charges and we know the electric field due to single point charge. So first we will calculate electric field due to positive charge at P, then electric field due to negative charge at P, and then finally use addition theorem. Whatever we can do, positive or negative, depending upon the direction, so the vector, and then we obtain result. To find direction, assume Q naught or test charge is point P. So this charge, positive charge, will repel this side. So electric field vector due to positive charge will be towards right. Electric field vector due to B is towards left. Now see, these two vectors are lying in opposite directions. So whenever you find resultant, it will be equal to the difference of these two vectors. Now electric field at P, electric field at P due to charge A, EA is equal to what? K Q over R minus A whole square. I can give equation 2. Similarly, electric field at P due to charge B, EB is equal to KQ over R plus A whole square. because from point P the distance from here to here is R and this plus A. Therefore, net electric field at P, that is E net, is equal to E A minus E B. KQ you can take common, in the bracket you will have 1 minus R A whole square, 1 over R A plus whole square, take LCM, relax and solve. You will get R square minus A square whole square. Here you will have R plus A whole square, R minus A whole square. This is A plus B whole square minus A minus B whole square. Right? So this is always 4AB. For this you can use formula A plus B whole square minus A minus B whole square is 4AB. So electric field at electric field is KQ. 4AR by R square minus A square whole square. Now you can take out 2 from this 4A and then Q into 2A by definition becomes dipole moment. See here. So you can write this expression as 2KQ into 2A into R divided by R square minus A square whole square. Right? So finally, final answer you can easily get it. That comes out En equals to K in 2K into P over R square minus A square. For short dipole, condition is R is very very larger than A, then you can neglect A, then En is equal to 2KP, R is also here, KP R by R raised to the power 4, and finally it comes out 2KP over R Q. That's how you can calculate electric field at an axial point of a diode. Of an electric dipole. Next we will continue with electric field at an equatorial point. Electric field at an equatorial point. So equatorial point of a dipole. So again consider a dipole, one positive, one negative charge, point A, charge Q, charge Q, point B, separation distance is 2A and equatorial point P at distance R. Now you have to locate the direction of electric field at this point. So assume test charge is kept here. Test charge is positive, so the direction of electric field due to positive charge will be this. Ea due to negative charge will be this. Eb. Clear? This angle is theta. This also I assume theta. Then this is 2 theta. By using Pythagoras, this side will be equal to R square plus A square. So after knowing this diagram, how do we calculate electric field at point P because of this electric dipole? Forget about it is equatorial or axial point. You work according to a simple problem. एक पॉजिटिव चार्ज है, एक नेगेटिव चार्ज है, टेस्ट चार्ज रख के आपने डायरेक्शंस निकाल ली. दिस टू इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड वेक्टर ईए एंड ईबी आर इंक्लाइंड एट एन एंगल 2 थीटा. लॉ ऑफ पैरेललोग्राम लगाओ, काम खत्म. सो फर्स्ट कैलकुलेट मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ ईए. इज इक्वल टू व्हाट? के क्यू ओवर R square plus A square. It is a square root, so when you square, you will get this answer. Magnitude of EB, that will be again same. So it is, it seems very good. Now you have two vectors which are equal in magnitude. Therefore, EA is equal to EB, and we consider that this is X. So straight we apply law of parallelogram result. Therefore, the resultant electric field at P, that is ER, is equal to square root of E1 square, E2 square, 2 mod of E1 mod of E2 cos 2 theta. Fine, this you can give it as equation number 3. Now E1, E2 you can put it as X. So ER is equal to X square plus X square plus 2X square cos 2 theta is square root of this. X square you can take common, so in the bracket you will have 2 plus 2 cos 2 theta. This you can write it as 2 1 plus cos 2 theta. Use formula cos 2 theta is equal to 2 cos square theta minus 1. So final answer you will get 2x cos theta. Now just put the value. 2x is kq over r square plus a square. Cos theta from this triangle you can get, if I say this is center point is M, so from right angle triangle PMA cos theta is base is A, hypotenuse is A square R square plus A square, Q into 2A becomes P, so P over R square plus A square raised to the power 3/2. This is the answer. For short dipole, R is greater than A, so neglect A, then you will have ER is equal to KP over RQ. So if you look at the result of electric field obtained in case of electric dipole, you will find that magnitude of electric field due to dipole decreases and increases faster than a single point charge, because in a point charge electric field varies reciprocal to R square, and here it is varying 1 by R cube. So even if you increase the value of R by a little, the electric field will fall drastically. Let's see what happened when electric dipole in uniform electric field. So consider electric dipole is kept in uniform electric field. This is in a uniform electric field is always represented by equally spaced line. The strength of electric field I say it is E, and this is an electric dipole held. A magnitude is Q, this is minus Q, this is point B. Now when you at an inclined at an angle theta, positive charge Q will experience force in the direction of electric field equals to QE. Electric force experienced by negative charge is in opposite direction to the field because charge is negative. So force on positive charge F A equals to plus QE, force on negative charge FB equals to minus QE, total force acting on system F is equal to FA plus FB, that comes out plus QE minus QE equals to zero. So net force is acting on a charge or system is zero. However, it will experience a torque because there are two forces which are acting in opposite direction. So the torque by definition is equal to R cross F, that you can also write as force into perpendicular distance between two forces. So quickly you can work it out on this issue also. Force is QE, perpendicular distance is AC. So from right angle triangle ACB, AC is equal to 2A sin theta because separation distance is 2A. So Q into 2A into E, that is cos sin theta. This is PE sin theta, that is P is equal to P, sorry, torque is equal to P cross E. It is a cross product of electric dipole movement and electric field vector, right? So direction of electric direction of torque will be at right angle to the plane formed by P and E. A special case 1, when theta is equal to 0, sin theta sin 0 is 0, torque is equal to 0, this is called stable equilibrium state. Case 2, when theta is equal to 180 degree, sine 180 is again 0, so torque is 0, this is called unstable equilibrium. Fine. Case 3, when theta is 90 degree, that is dipole is held perpendicular, sin 90 is 1, so torque is maximum equal to P into E. Right, I hope that you know the difference between stable and unstable equilibrium. If not, then I will show you what. Now I can explain you what is stable equilibrium and unstable equilibrium with an easy device. This is a remote. You see, I kept the remote like this. When remote is kept like this, if I push this remote little bit, you see its position of equilibrium of rest has changed. This is one situation. Now see second situation. I keep the remote like this. Now I try to change the position of the remote. I lift it up and left. What happened? It has come back to its initial position. I lifted it more. Release. What happened? It has come back to its initial position. Lifted it more and leave. What happened? It has come back to its initial position. So the first case is unstable equilibrium, where body appears stable in a state of rest, but if slight force acts on it, it loses its equilibrium. While this second case is an example of stable equilibrium, where we are applying force and it becomes very difficult to change the equilibrium state of the body. See it again quickly. This is in a state of rest. Little force is applied. State has changed. If this much force is applied, released, it has come back. Now we have seen that when electric dipole is kept in uniform electric field, it does not experience force but experiences torque. What torque actually does, that you know from class 11th. Torque always rotates a body. So next related article is electric potential energy of dipole. Consider a torque rotates a dipole by an angle d theta. Then work done. dW is equal to torque into d theta. So total work done W is equal to integration of dW. Integration torque is PE sin theta d theta. Let's see the net changes in the angle. Initial position is theta 1, final is theta 2. So PE you can take outside of the integration. Integration of sin theta d theta, theta 1 to theta 2 is equal to, let's put it down, PE, this is minus cos theta, theta 1 to theta 2, that you can put it as minus PE cos theta 2 minus cos theta 1. This work then actually is stored in an electric dipole in form of potential energy. Right? So as we know from work energy theorem, work done is always stored in form of potential energy. So this is also stored in form of potential energy. Let's take a special case. If theta 1 is equal to 90 degree and theta 2 is equal to theta, so u is equal to minus p cos theta. This is very well used. We can say this is equation 3, 4, 5. This is very well used in the board examinations. Let's take an example. An electric dipole length is 4 cm placed with its axis. An electric dipole, listen me carefully, electric dipole of length 4 cm, it means 2A is equal to 4 cm, that is 4 into 10 raised to the power minus 2 meter. When placed with its axis making angle theta is equal to how much? 60 degree. with uniform electric field experiences a torque is equal to 4 root 3 Newton meter. Calculate magnitude of E. First question, what is E? You have to calculate. Charge is given, Q is given as plus minus 8 nanocoulomb. Nanocoulomb means 8 into 10 raised to the power minus 9 coulomb. So P is equal to 8 into, or you can, let me write formula also for you, that will help you. Q into 2A, that is 8 into 4 into 10 raised to power minus 2 into 10 raised to the power 32 into 10 raised to the power minus 11 coulomb meter. Fine. Now you can use easily, torque is equal to PE sin theta. So P is 32 into 10 raised to power minus 11 into E sin 60 is root 3 by 2. Torque is 4 root 3. So root 3 cancel. This E becomes equal to 8 into 32 into 10 raised to the power 8. This is 8, divide 8, 4 jar, 32, this here comes 8, 8, 4 jar, 32, so this comes out 2.5 into 10 raised to the power 10 newton per coulomb. Another part is calculate potential energy. So how to calculate potential energy? Use formula now. Same formula. U is equal to minus PE cos theta. P is how much? 32 into 10 raised to power minus 11. E is 2.5 into 10 raised to the power 10. Cos 60 is 1 by 2. So, what is the answer? Minus 4 joule. This is 10 raised to 2.5 into 10 raised to the power 10, not 10 raised to the power. Right? Let's take one more example quickly. This question goes like this. A system of 2-point charges QA are located. This says here, this coordinates are 0, 0, 15. Coordinates are 0, 0, minus 15 centimeter. Yes. And 2 into 10 raised to the power minus 7. 2 into 10 raised to power minus 7. 2.5 here. Minus 2.5 10 raised to power minus 7 coulomb here. What is needed? In question it is asked to calculate electric dipole moment. So electric dipole moment is simple. P is equal to Q into 2A. 2.5 into 10 raised to the power minus 7. Distance between these two points is 15 plus 50, 30 centimeter into 10 raised to the power minus 2. 75 into 10 raised to the power minus 9. That you can say 7.5 into 10 raised to the power minus 8 coulomb meter. Right? Another question. An electric dipole, example 3, an electric dipole moment, with dipole moment P is equal to 4 into 10 raised to the power minus 9 coulomb meter, is placed at an angle of 30 degree with the direction of angle theta is equal to 30 degree. Fine. Electric field is equal to 5 into 10 raised to the power 4 Newton per coulomb. Question says calculate torque. Is it torque is equal to P sin theta 4 into 10 raised to power minus 9 5 into 10 raised to the power 4 sin 30 20 into 10 raised to the power minus 5 1 by 2 10 into 10 raised to the power minus 5. So answer is 10 raised to the power minus 4 Newton meter. That's what. So simple questions are asked in the board examination, provided you are clear about the formula.